I'm Lauren Stern.
I am Oliver DiCerbo. My friends call me Ollie.
And I will be competing in the Chicken McNugget Showdown.
And I will be competing for the 45-minute Chicken McNugget Challenge tomorrow.
Who will you be competing against?
Against Ollie DiCerbo.
Lauren Stern.
Hi, I'm Nika Piruz. I am Lauren's tally marker and her second.
I'm Nick Porter. I'll be the tally man and substitute for Ollie.
This will be my first chicken nugget eating competition, but I am very confident in my abilities, especially going up against Lauren Stern.
He's just going to absolutely wipe the floor with Lauren. I think that's the only thing he can do at this point.
I don't like how confident he is.
Okay.
I think that he's a little overconfident.
I think Lauren is overconfident. She has been trash-talking me all week since the competition arose, and she said, "I have brothers, I'm gonna beat you." And I said, "I have brothers too." And she said, "It's different, I'm a girl."
I think that he's comparing the girl and boy thing as like the main leg up he has.
Now, could you say one kind thing about your opponent, Oliver DiCerbo?
Yeah, I mean, Ollie's a great kid. I think that he's really excited. He always brings a good attitude, willing to try anything. That's why I think he committed to this, so it's exciting.
And one thing that you like about Lauren Stern?
I think I'm gonna feel very anxious right when it starts. You know what I mean? It's like when you step into a soccer game, you're like, "Oh, this is so fun," and then all of a sudden, like, you're all lined up, and the ref blows the whistle, like, "Oh fuck, I have to actually play the game now," and like, I don't know how to kick a soccer ball. That's kind of the feeling you're gonna feel.
The loser has to wear the other person's clothes chosen by the winner.
And if you lose, you have to wear the opponent's clothing to an in-school school day.
How many Chicken McNuggets do you plan on eating tomorrow?
So, originally when we made this, I gung-ho said I could eat 70.
70.
Honestly, I have no idea how many I can eat. I know I can eat more than 20. Other than that, I'm not sure.
I think it's all just going to come down to natural talent. Got loads of that. Give me no issue.
I want to see Lauren Stern get the gold.
I think that the world is divided by, are you a sauce person or are you not?
Hot and spicy.
Girl clothes.
Pensive aggression.
Literally against all my ideology. I had one peanut butter and jelly sandwich at 7:50 in the morning. I had 3 sips of a cold brew coffee with Splenda and 3 creams. And then I had a whole Hershey's chocolate bar. So I feel like that was good, fast sugar.
Thank you.
You got a Snapchat from Koi.
Okay, hold on. I have to read the rules. So I have to listen.
Whistle again. Whistle.
Hey, Sam. Wait, Ollie, what's Ollie's middle name?
You can head over to like over there. We're gonna walk you up, okay?
Where?
Like I don't know, behind the bush or something.
I did.
Yeah, you go with him.
Oh. Oh great, you just wrote my name.
No, we did DKS up here.
When you DKS for
you. You don't have a middle name.
Yeah, no,
I know. They called me last night.
Can you guys go over like behind the bush? We're gonna walk you up, okay?
I don't wanna walk out. I didn't do it.
My name is Evan Eberly, and I'm a friend of Oliver DiCerbo.
Sisters.
My sign says Ollie wants to wear girl clothes.
I would like to see him in girls' clothes, though, what she said. I would like to see him in girls' clothes at school. I just wouldn't want to be at LHS while he was in the outfit. But
I think that Ollie's going to lose on purpose so we can wear Lauren's clothes to school.
3, 2, 1, begin.
All right, Lauren.
This is the official time, by the way. We forgot to take the baby.
Oh, God. Ollie, it's not open his gift.
You got a little.
No, you don't tell it till it's swallowed.
Hi, I'm Regina. I'm a junior.
And who are you here supporting today, Regina?
Well, I mean, you know, I want to support Lauren because, go girl, you know. But I think I'm really going to support Ollie because he's not a basketball guy. So I really want to see him eat as much basketball as he can.
Hello, my name is Kyuho. I am a senior at LHS. Lauren went for a whole ass block, and he only got up 3 nuggets. So
interesting.
A little worried, but I think he pulled through.
Mid-game interview, are you
I'm
ready?
I'm feeling good. I'm at what, 52? 52. I'm feeling good.
Lauren decided to go to scrub.
How
it's 37. She's literally dumping them in water. It's disgusting.
Do it, Lauren. Submit, Lauren.
Are you feeling confident for the back 20 here?
I am. She's struggling. I'm not even full yet.
Described as the battle of the sexes. You know, I got a root for my kind here. Obviously, I'm rooting for her, but I don't think she would make it. I think she would. She'd have to do a lot to become close to where he's at right now.
All right. We're just surviving. This is the end here.
Last one.
2 minutes.
Poor Charlie.
Two minutes on the clock.
Come on. You got 10.
What?
Last one until the next one.
There's a minute. No, 2 minutes.
To settle the start?
It's all documented. You said it.
There's no way
that starts
to stop that.
I don't know why the graphics
said it.
Always that one. Yes.
2, 1.
I think if I run there, I'll feel better. Oh my god, I feel so.
You know, after all those nuggets, I'm really full. I'm not gonna lie. Oh god. Oh, now they're splitting the. You know, I don't think I'm gonna throw up, but I'm close.
Oh my god, I've never felt worse in my life.
You got the 40.
Oh god. That's a heat. Okay, I think I'm gonna vomit right now.
No, it's gonna be good story to tell. When you're done with work, I'm gonna vomit.
Woo! Why is she running?
Fool. That is foolish.
For the documentary.
I
gotta get back. Okay. Hold on. I don't even know if I can vomit. I just like. So mean. Oh god, I feel so bad.
Why is
Evan
gonna
do it? I told Evan to turn the camera off.
To be honest, I knew Ollie was gonna win. Oh. If I'm being 100% honest, I knew there's literally no way I could have won. But I felt so horrible. Like, I did not expect it to be that painful.
I told you it's for the documentary.
I think we should film it, and Lauren can decide later if she wants today. But I think
clearly, Lauren isn't in the right state of mind right now.
No,
there was a little bit. I got it on video. Oh dear. Releasing pressure. They're gonna take all my nuggets, and I paid $5.
Oh yeah.
That is so gross. I hate my life.
Your run, 10 nuggets in. Could you explain that to us?
Totally. And that was more like a trial error thing. And what I learned from that is that was an error. And I wanted to die.
At no point was I really scared of losing. Lauren, although a valiant competitor, she didn't end up putting up much of the fight, which I thought it was going to be a little bit more. I'd say for the first 26 nuggets, I'd say we were pretty close. I was like ahead of her by probably 3 going into those like early stages. And then when it started slowing down, she started struggling a lot, and you know, I just pretty much maintained a speed about 1.3 nuggets per minute, and you know, I came out with it.
I wanted to die like 5 nuggets in, to be honest.
And then by 30, you know, she was laying on the ground, so, and Nika was feeding them to her, so like, that's the point where I just was able to pull away.
Wait, do you want ketchup?
You know when you have a plastic bag, like a Ziploc plastic bag, and you want to fill it with like popcorn, and you stuff it in and you zip it, and then you can't zip it, so you have to like take it all out. Like my stomach was like the max popcorn you could fill into that plastic bag. Like it was like a trash can. I don't know how my muscles were doing it, but they just kept squishing them down. And I was able to get more nuggets.
Because I think that I came in with the wrong preparation. Like I think my preparation went really south today, and I wasn't in the right. Like my body didn't feel right. So I think I could have done better. I'm not saying I could do a lot better. I'm saying I think it could be more pleasant.
Yeah, I think the run was a mistake.
No, I don't. For me, it wasn't the run. For me, it was the coffee. Coffee really fucks me up.
I also think you. My thing was when I told you I was empty. I was full at that point. Like I was mentally staying ahead of you. You know what I mean? It was intimidation.
Well, if I can give any advice, it would say never do it.
But honestly, with given the right opponent, I'd sign up.
I didn't weigh myself, but I gained 6 pounds of emotional trauma.
Like,
it was a good run.
Yeah, it was.
It's good to entertainment.
Yeah, I hope we entertained. I'm nice in Nantucketopoly. Anyone challenge me in Nantucketopoly?
What's Nantucketopoly?
It's Monopoly, but like Nantucket buildings and like stores.
That's dumb as shit.
I'll be in Monopoly.
That's all Cisco Monopoly. That's like,
okay, fine. Monopoly.
I'll whoop your ass in Dogopoly.
Dogopoly. Yeah.
How about Baseballnopoly?
Baseballonopoly.
That's how I used to play as a kid.
I've never played that.
How? I think I could beat you in
any Monopoly. I'd win. I'm nice in Monopoly.
Monopoly. No,
or any other food challenge. Our body types just aren't the same.
Everybody's
I'm simply built different.
I think that's
two
just
player,
not true.
Everybody's it.
I think that I could beat you in Trivial Pursuit. Listen, baby. Ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide. You don't have